A beautiful figure for a nutcracker. Quite a new model. With a screw jaw opening down into his waistcoat, he'd be lovely."
"Not ugly enough," said Tackleton.
"Or for a firebox, either," observed Caleb, in deep contemplation. "What a model! Unscrew his head to put the matches in. Turn him heels upwards for the light. And what a firebox for a gentleman's mantel-shelf, just as he stands!"
"Not half ugly enough," said Tackleton. "Nothing in him at all. Come, bring that box. All right now, I hope?"
"Oh, quite gone, quite gone," said the little woman, waving him hurriedly away. "Good night."
"Good night," said Tackleton. "Good night, John Peerybingle. Take care how you carry that box, Caleb. Let it fall and I'll murder you. Dark as pitch and weather worse than ever, eh? Good night."
So, with another sharp look round the room, he went out at the door, followed by Caleb with the wedding cake on his head. The carrier had been so much astounded by his little wife, and so busily engaged in soothing and tending her, that he had scarcely been conscious of the stranger's presence until now, when he again stood there, their only guest.
"He don't belong to them, you see," said John. "I must give him a hint to go."
"I beg your pardon, friend," said the old gentleman, advancing to him. "The more so, as I fear your wife has not been well. But the attendant whom my infirmity," he touched his ears and shook his head, "renders almost indispensable, not having arrived, I fear there must be some mistake.